Denver 7 Now is sponsored by Ferguson and BAC Appliance Center, the best in bath, kitchen, and lighting for your home.
I'm Ann Trujillo with the latest from Denver 7. Tonight, we know Colorado's Catholic Church has received dozens of claims of sexual abuse at the hands of clergy. That confession came with a promise that survivors would be paid for their suffering as long as they agree not to take the church to court. Contact 7 investigates Tony Kowaleski has been pressing the church to be more accountable.
This is going to be independent.
Colorado's Attorney General making the ground rules clear.
The amount of money to be awarded, the decisions are not overseen by the diocese. They are managed solely by our special masters.
Phil Weiser saying money paid to victims will come from the Catholic Church, and the church will not contribute to the decisions made on who gets money and how much.
There were some painful compromises that we had to make to get to a final agreement.
Today's announcement for victims' compensation comes 2 weeks after former Attorney General Cynthia Kaufman and a former priest and longtime critic of the church both criticized the depth and scope of the ongoing investigation.
I think it's a farce. And I think it's a farce because it's cooked up mainly to benefit and cover for the institutional church.
Would it be accurate for us to report that you didn't get everything you wanted from the Catholic Church in this negotiation?
Yes, it would be accurate.
Disappointing?
Disappointing.
To avoid future disappointments, Colorado's Attorney General has hired a respected independent administrator to consider all claims with a focus on arriving at a fair and just compensation for victims.
Many of these claimants, even more than the compensation, want validation, want acknowledgement, want to hear from independent administrators, yes, your claim is credible. Yes, you were harmed. Yes, it's a tragedy what was done to you.
The independent administrator said cash payouts will likely be between $10,000 and $500,000, but there is no ceiling on that amount. Settlements will be based on details uncovered during the process.
So we want to know the nature of the abuse. We also look very carefully at the number of incidents of the abuse. What we have learned around the country is that there are victims who have been abused once, and there have been victims who have been abused over 100 times.
Now, all the settlement money will come from the Catholic Church and not from taxpayers. So if you or someone you know was victimized by a priest, we have the hotline to report that abuse posted on our website. Tonight, we are monitoring an escalating situation in Fairplay where a teacher strike is now set to begin as early as next Monday. Park County administrators and teachers are tentatively planning to hold an all-day meeting on Wednesday. However, the union tells Denver 7 it has little faith the district will even show up to the meeting, much less come to a compromise on pay. A jury could begin weighing the fate of a Denver Uber driver charged with murder. They could begin as early as tomorrow. From the beginning, Michael Hancock has maintained that he was defending his own life when he shot and killed a passenger, Hyun Kim, on the side of I-25. Hancock insists Kim began attacking him as he drove. Ballistics, however, show the shots were likely fired from outside the car. Closing statements are set for the morning. New information tonight on a woman seen spouting vile and racist remarks towards CU Boulder students. In a now viral video, she appears unhinged and angry as she argues with and repeatedly calls students the N-word. Well, police tell us tonight she's not a student or an employee of the university, and they believe she's the same woman caught camping on campus last month. Aurora leaders are putting pressure on the local ICE facility to actually tell the public when there is an issue. A vote tonight would require the company running the detention center to publicly acknowledge when there's been a disease outbreak. This move follows incidents like the one from March, when a mumps scare left 65 people under quarantine for more than 2 months. A second vote will be required if tonight's passes. King Soopers and City Market stores will stop selling e-cigarettes. That will happen just as soon as their supply runs out. 9 cases of a severe vaping-related illness have been confirmed in Colorado, and that number could rise when new numbers are released on Wednesday. Our Colorado's growth will bring a new grocery store to Denver's coal neighborhood. It also is likely to blame for locals losing one of the only places they could currently shop. This tiny store on North Downing Street might not look like much to you, but for neighbors, this represented fresh food within walking distance, and now it's closed. And it could be the end of next year before that community sees a replacement. Denver 7's Liz Gilardi has the story.
Very disappointed.
Shoppers showed up and peered through the glass. The sign on the door of this small neighborhood grocery store says closed, and that closure leaves a real void here in Denver's coal neighborhood.
And have consistently been asking for access to food, fresh food.
Councilwoman Candy Sitabaca worries about food deserts, areas that lack access to fresh food. This was pretty much the only grocery store in the area where you could buy fruit, vegetables, and meat.
The closest full service grocery store is Safeway down here on Park Ave. You have Natural Grocers right up the street on Brighton, but that, since the beginning, has not been affordable for the community that it plopped into.
One of the partners for Downing Super told me it was time to go, pointing to increasing rent and property taxes. He also said a lot of longtime customers have moved.
For the neighborhood, I expect it's going to be great.
David Williams grew up in the neighborhood and he's seen the area change. Now, after more than 40 years, the store he's been going to for decades is gone.
Now they don't have anything, and people that didn't have a vehicle that caught the bus, well, the way they are, the streets torn up now, they're at a total disadvantage.
There are signs all around. The neighborhood is transforming. There's even plans for a new grocery store and 200 apartments. But that project is just getting underway. And until it opens, residents will have to leave their neighborhood to find fresh food. Liz Gilardi, Denver 7.
And now from the First Alert Weather Center, here's a look at your forecast. We're in for a warm couple of days next, Tuesday and Wednesday. And then on Thursday, snow and cold move in. This has been your Denver 7 On Demand update. Thanks for joining us. Check back here later tonight for another update. And download the Denver 7 app for breaking news and alerts. I'm Ann Trujillo.